The secular dictionary defines hell as a nether world in which the dead continue to exist, also termed as Hades. The other definition of hell is a nether realm of Satan and his demons, in where condemned people suffer everlasting punishment. Hell is a real place which exists in the spiritual realms under the earth. And it is where all souls that have led their physical earthly lives in wickedness, worldliness, evil, and sinfulness end up, after they die. However, for many years now, hell has been viewed by the inhabitants of the earth as just a fable and myth that is just meant to scare people so that they may adhere to good moral behavior. But they don't know that hell is a real place which serves as the final destination of all the wicked of the human race. Many human beings that have existed and exist on the earth think that hell is a joke, that hell is just a game, and so they are careless with how they live their lives on earth. They don't care as to their actions while they are alive on the earth, they just live for fun and personal satisfaction, totally oblivious of the consequences of their actions. Many live for the here and now, they don't give a damn about their final destination. Due to this fact, many human beings easily and happily step into every trap that Satan has set up on the earth, to capture and harvest souls, and afterward condemn them into hell. Since many human beings simply don't fear hell, and they think it's a joke, they easily surrender control of their lives to the sinful and evil nature inside them. And because of this, they end up going out into the world, to the altars, industries, and contact points that Satan has instituted on the earth. And once there, the human beings practice and take part in all kinds of wicked acts, perversions, depraved practices and abominations that Satan has placed in those altars. Human beings take part in all this, in satisfaction of the sinful desires, wicked passions, evil lusts and filthy appetites, that are at work inside their evil flesh. Many of the wicked acts which they practice, become addictions and lifestyles for them, and they end up practicing them always for the rest of their lives. Since many people do not know about hell, and many more think that is just a joke and a myth, they end up leaving their entire lives practicing evil, wickedness and sin, not knowing that their souls are in danger of everlasting destruction in the flames of hell. Since people don't fear hell, they simply don't fear the wicked practices and evil indulgences that have been institutionalized by Satan in the world. Because of this, many human beings end up living their lives to the glory of Satan, by living a life that is full of the wicked practices and evil indulgences of the world. This sets the trajectory of their lives towards the final destination of hell and the lake of fire. This is the saddest situation that arises from lack of knowledge or ignorance of hell in the midst of the human race. The trajectories of the lives of many human inhabitants of the earth is set for hell, and yet many don't even know it, and those who know it think is a fable, myth, and a huge joke, and because of this they simply don't care. If the human inhabitants of the earth had known about hell and about the seriousness of hell, then many of them, just out of the fear of ending up in that everlasting destructive place, would have avoided wickedness and kept themselves safe from the many traps and stumbling blocks that Satan has established on the earth to harvest souls for him. If mankind feared hell, then they would have been more careful about what they subscribe to in the world. And in this way, many lives of men would have been preserved from being destroyed and ruined by Satan and his demons through evil indulgence and wicked practice. If humanity knew about the seriousness and everlasting nature of hell, many of them would have restrained themselves from taking part in the wicked practices and evil indulgences that are full in the world, which people do in order to satisfy the sinful desires, wicked passions, evil lusts, and filthy appetites that exist in their evil flesh. So the lack of knowledge of hell, and the lack of seriousness regarding the reality of hell, in the midst of the human race, has handed a huge blow to God's plan of reconciling humanity to himself. For many human beings just easily and carelessly hand themselves over to destruction, and to the wicked practices that are on the earth. In the same way, the lack of knowledge of hell, and the lack of seriousness of human beings towards the entity of hell, has greatly helped Satan in his efforts to steal, degrade, destroy and condemn the human race. For since many don't know about hell, and those who know about it consider it a joke, they have let their guard down, and their lives on earth have become playing grounds for Satan and his demons. So Satan easily establishes himself in the lives of human beings, and they end up living their entire lives practicing wickedness, and taking part in evil indulgences on the earth, to the glory and praise of Satan. This sinful living, to the glory and praise of Satan on the earth, puts a stamp and seal on their eternal destiny, to be like that one of Satan and his demons, which is hell and the lake of fire. In this section of the teachings about hell, I'm going to look at the origin of hell, that is, exactly where it came from, and for what purpose it was created. Hell was created by God Almighty, the creator of the heavens and the earth, and the father of all existence. He was the one who created hell after the rebellion of Lucifer and his angels, to be the quarantine, prison, storehouse, and punisher of the dominion of darkness, which consists of Satan and his angels, the demons. The reason why God created hell, was because Lucifer and his angels, in the raving madness and depravity of the evil that was at work in their hearts, actually tried to overthrow God Almighty, the Father of existence, from his seat of authority in heaven. So you can imagine a creature created, trying to overthrow and take the authority of the one who created it. And the creator we are talking about, is none other than God Almighty, the creator of the universe. Just imagine, who, in their right state of mind, could even try to lift a finger against the owner of the universe, leave alone trying to overthrow him and usurp his authority. The creation itself testifies of the greatness, majesty, and magnificence of God Almighty. Just looking at the creation itself, should make you fear and stand in awe, of God Almighty. But Lucifer and a third of the angels that he had stolen from God, were too blinded by the evil that was in them, to even consider this. So in their evil perpetrations they did the unthinkable, and actually tried to overthrow God from his seat of majesty. This level of evil perpetration of Lucifer and his angels, which amounts to madness of the highest degree, is what drove God into a furious wrathful rage. God was so angry and enraged by the fact that they even tried to overthrow him. How dare they? He was so enraged, that in the indignation of his righteous anger the foundations of heaven were shaken. And on that day, the angels of God got to see the other side of their Creator, that they had never seen ever since heaven was established. The entire of heaven shook violently with the wrathful anger of God, raging indignation, and all the angels of God for the first time were filled with fear, and they all trembled. Then out of the material, of pure righteous anger, fury, and rage, God Almighty created the entity of hell and the entity of the lake of fire. He created hell as a torture house, which is designed to come up with every kind of sadistic mechanism, and way of inflicting non-stop torture and pain on the bodies of Lucifer and his angels. All this as they await for the final judgment, where they would be thrown into the lake of fire for their eternal death. Hell is therefore a live creature, created by God like you and I, but instead of being created out of God's goodness, it was created out of his furious anger and wrath against the sins of Lucifer and his angels. God created and designed hell for the sole purpose of imprisoning, torturing, and inflicting severe pain, suffering, and anguish on Satan and his angels, as punishment for their most evil perpetration of trying to overthrow God. Hell does not get satisfied of torturing or even tired of inflicting pain and suffering. It does not run out of energy, or run out of ideas of how to torture or inflict pain. It does it continuously without stopping, without taking a break. It was designed by God Almighty to torture Satan and his demons continuously for all time, until they get thrown into the lake of fire. So hell was created by God Almighty, to be the storehouse of the dominion of darkness, who are the wicked of his creation. Please subscribe to the channel, press the bell notification, to be always notified of new uploads. Thank you in advance. In order to understand how hell made its way to the earth, we have to understand that God and his angels are spiritual in nature. They therefore exist in the spiritual dimension of existence. And because of this, hell, which God created as a prison for Satan and his demons, is also a spiritual entity. When God created hell, he placed it afloat in the second heaven of the spiritual dimension of the universe. that is far above the physical dimension of the universe, which exists as an extensive belt, consisting of many trillions of galaxies, spread out at the base of the second heaven. So hell was in the second heaven, which also hosts the many galaxies that make up the physical dimension of the universe. When Satan projected himself from hell by his spirit, and took up residence inside the snake in the Garden of Eden, he tempted Eve to sin by disobeying God's command, by eating the fruit of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. When this happened, then human beings who are physical life forms that exist in the physical dimension of the universe, shifted into the dark side just like Satan and the demons, and they became part and parcel of the dominion of darkness who are the wicked of God's creation. When human beings shifted into the darkness and joined the League of the Fallen, that consists of Satan and his demons, then God Almighty was forced to relocate hell, bringing it into the spiritual dimensions of the earth. God did this so that, when human beings who had become wicked, physically die, then their evil and wicked souls, end up in hell, which is the storehouse of torture, for all of God's creation that subscribes to evil and wicked practice. God placed hell, which is a spiritual entity, in the spiritual realms inside the planet Earth. Like I have said, this was for the sake of ease, so that the souls of human beings that die evil and wicked, on the surface of the earth, may just be easily led into hell. Therefore, hell made its way into the earth and into the lives of humanity, because of the shift of the human race, into the dark side, after the fall in the Garden of Eden. After the fall, human beings became evil and sinful in nature, and they therefore joined Satan and his demons in being part and parcel of the wicked of God's creation. Because of becoming evil in nature, human beings inherited the hopeless destiny of hell and the lake of fire, which God had created exclusively for Satan and his demons. So today, hell exists inside the planet Earth, but in the spiritual realm, and it was placed there by God Almighty in order to receive, punish, torture, and store the souls of the wicked human beings who have died on the earth while wicked and evil. The furnace and storehouse of hell plays host to Satan, the demons, and now human beings. They are all reserved there, in torture, punishment, suffering, anguish and pain, until the day of the final judgment, when they will all be thrown into the lake of fire. Since the entity of hell was created by God not out of the goodness that abides in him, but out of the pure furious anger of his raging indignation, hell is infinitely evil, hateful, cruel, sadistic, torturous, and destructive, more than one can possibly imagine. It exists this way because it was created out of the raging wrath of God with zero love. Because of this, the personality and character of the entity of hell is such that it is designed to show no mercy, no remorse, no love, no consideration whatsoever to the subjects of its torture. Hell was designed to be relentless in torturing and inflicting pain on the bodies of all the creatures that are there. It never runs out of energy in running every mechanism of torture in it, it never gets tired of inflicting pain and torture on those inside it, it never gets satisfied of inflicting pain and suffering, or become filled up with human beings. It is always ever expanding as more and more human beings continue entering it. Due to this, hell is capable of torturing everybody and anybody inside it forever and ever and ever, without ever stopping even for a second. Because of this, the torture of the souls of the human beings that end up in that place is continuous and relentless. If, for example, hell has designed and come up with a mechanism for your torture that involves being dipped in boiling oil and being cooked by that boiling oil, then you will be thrown inside the boiling oil, and then you will cook inside that boiling oil while feeling every inch of pain in your flesh, until all your flesh melts in the oil. Then after that, hell will take you out of the oil and your body will be refreshed again, and then you'll be thrown into the oil to endure the same pain all over again. This will become the cycle of your torture, and it will continue relentlessly for all time, without there being any break. That is just how relentless hell is. You will be tortured the same way over and over and over and over and over again for all time, and maybe the only break that you'll have will be in the second judgment, where all human souls will stand before God to account for everything that they have ever done. But after this, you'll be thrown into a place of torture that is even more worse than hell, and this is the lake of fire. Such is the dreadfulness and horrendousness of hell. It is a place of tangible sadness, tangible hatred, tangible hopelessness, a place of non-ending pain, non-ending suffering, that produces unimaginable anguish in the hearts of those that are there. It is a place that will make you wish that you could just cease to exist, that will make you even curse your mother's womb for giving birth to you. It is a place that will make you miss being alive on the earth, even if your life on the earth was the most miserable and full of problems. Hell is the most horrendous place on earth. If you knew it, then you could never even wish it as a punishment on your worst enemy on the surface of the earth. Hell as a habitation is a place that has an atmosphere of death, where the prevailing smell is that of rotten flesh, and burning sulfur that smells like burning tires. The smell itself is nauseating, pungent and choking. It will make you feel like covering your nose, but you cannot, since hell cannot allow it. There is very little breathable air in hell, and in many places, the souls are subjected to a continuous cycle of gasping for breath but cannot find it, and they cannot die of suffocation or asphyxiation, so they just continue on existing in a perpetual cycle of gasping for breath. This is because most of the air is used up by the flames of hell, that are ever blazing, and you are continually always competing with the flames for air. In hell, the prevailing sound of the atmosphere of hell is the sound of groaning, moaning, crying, and screaming in the pain and suffering of the torture, torment, destruction and anguish of the souls of the people who are in hell. Some cry for help, others cry for mercy, others cry to be taken out of there, while others curse their mother's wombs for bringing them into existence. Hell is full of sulfur fire, that continuously burns with undying flames that perpetually burn inside hell. This flames burn the flesh of all the souls that are in hell, continually and perpetually, and once their flesh is completely burnt up by the flames, hell refreshes them by giving them new flesh, so that they may continue suffering from the pain of the burning of their flesh. The flames of hell make the atmosphere of hell to be hot, therefore all the souls who breathe in the air inside hell get their lungs and trachea scorched by the heat of the air that is inside hell. In hell, there is no light, but a deep tangible darkness that looks more like a blanket that engulfs all of hell. The only thing that is visible from one end of hell to the next is the flames that are ever blazing there, which have a reddish sulfur hue about themselves. The light from the flames is however diminished by the darkness inside hell, and nobody can see the other person's individual torments of tortures in hell, unless hell is punishing them as a group. The people in hell only feel the torture that is being inflicted upon them, by the mechanisms of punishments and torments, that hell has invented by its sadistic mind. Inside hell, God has placed a type of worm, that ranges about 6 inches and longer, whose purpose is to torment all those that are in hell, by biting and burrowing into their flesh, while eating and chewing them, digging deep into their flesh. This biting worms exist in hell in their billions, and inflict pain and suffering on the bodies of all those that are in hell, by biting them continuously and burrowing into their flesh. Each individual soul in hell is infested with hundreds if not thousands of these worms. These ones are very painful, and they ferociously and relentlessly bite and dig into the bodies of all of those that are there, and they do it anywhere, the burrow through the eyes, burrow through the ears, burrow through the skull, burrow through the hand, burrow through the stomach, through the back, through the private regions, etc. They are always ferociously digging into the flesh of the souls that are in hell. In any given moment hundreds of them may be digging in and out, inflicting so much pain, suffering and torment on the bodies of the souls that are in hell. The worms never cease to bite and burrow. They are always ever digging into the flesh of the souls that are in hell. Hell is filled with the ambience and preeminence of pure hatred, sadism, suffering, sadness and hopelessness. Because of this, all the souls that are there are in a state of perpetual depression, where they're continually sad and full of regret. The souls that are there are full of hatred and they hate each other with an infinite hate. There is no love in hell. There is no concern for each other's welfare in hell. There is only hatred, pain, anguish, suffering, and torment, with moans, groans, screams and cries of pain, anguish, regret and torment rising up from all the inhabitants of hell forever. In this section, I want us to see why God had to reduce the power of the furnace of hell, in order for it to accommodate and act as a torture house for human souls. Hell was originally designed to torture and torment Satan and his angels, who are spiritual beings of greater power, strength, and endurance. Hell in its full power and capacity is able to torment and torture even Satan himself and the demons. Now, when human beings fell in the garden, they shifted into the dark side and became evil in nature. They therefore became part and parcel of the wicked of God's creation, who are Satan and his demons, and therefore they became eligible to inherit hell and the lake of fire as their eternal destiny. And for this reason, God transferred hell from the place he had placed it in the second heaven, into the spiritual realms of the planet Earth, which is the habitation of the human race. Hell therefore exists in the belly of the earth, and it was placed there in order to receive the souls of all human beings that die while wicked and evil. When God brought hell into the spiritual realms of the planet Earth, he had to reduce the power of hell, so that hell may be capable of inflicting pain, torture, torment, suffering, and anguish as a punishment for all the wicked souls of mankind that find themselves in hell. The reason why God reduced the power of hell, was because hell in its maximum power, is meant to torture and inflict torment on Satan and his angels the demons, who are creatures of greater power, strength, and endurance compared to human beings. If human beings would have been thrown in hell while it was at its maximum power, then hell would have been like the lake of fire for human beings, who are feeble, weak, fragile, and with little endurance. Since God created hell for storage and punishment, and not for relentless destruction like it is with the lake of fire, he reduced the power of hell for the sake of the human race, so that, now hell had diminished power enough to torture, torment, and punish the fragile human beings that end up in there. But by God reducing the power of hell which he created as a furnace of torment for Satan and his demons, he made hell a little more tolerable for Satan and his demons. For this reason, Satan and his demons are no longer in torment inside hell, not that they don't feel pain, or don't suffer, but they are able to endure and tolerate the conditions in hell. For this reason, Satan's demons are now part and parcel of the torture framework of hell against human beings. So hell in its current state, is only powerful enough to torture and torment human beings, but it still acts as a prison and storehouse and confinement for the demons, even though it is not strong enough to torture them and torment them. Since the demons can now endure hell's flames, they use their time and energy there to torture and inflict pain on human beings, who are in God's image, as revenge against God. And they gain sadistic pleasure in tormenting human beings in hell. In hell, there are basic tortures and torments that are common for all the wicked souls of human beings, that end up in hell. These basic torments and tortures that are common to all who are in hell, are themselves enough, to make hell virtually unbearable and intolerable to the human being. These universal torments of hell, inflict so much pain, suffering and anguish, just by themselves, enough to make any human being wish he or she had never come to exist, due to the torment they inflict. Let's look at each of these universal torments and tortures exhaustively. The first torment or torture that consumes each and every soul of a human being that finds itself in hell, is the torture and torment through the ever-blazing sulfur flames of hell. As we have said, the entirety of hell is full of sulfur, that is constantly burning with furious flames, that continually and perpetually burn the flesh of every soul that is in hell, producing unbelievable pain that makes every soul in hell to perpetually cry and scream continuously. This ferocious flames of hell never die down, and they are constantly burning the bodies and flesh of everybody who is in hell. And after the flesh of any single soul becomes totally consumed, then hell renews their body, so that their flesh is brand new and ready for burning again. The flames of hell account for the hugest quantity of pain that radiates in the bodies of the souls that are in hell, torturing them and tormenting them, so that they perpetually cry and scream, and shout in the pain of the anguish of their torment through the flames. The pain through the consuming flames of hell is so intense, that the souls there gnash and grind their teeth while writhing in pain, so when they are not crying and screaming and shouting, then they are gnashing and grinding their teeth in pain. The second universal torment of hell, is the torture through the 6-inch plus worms that are always ever biting and burrowing through the flesh of every soul that is in hell. This 6-inch plus worms, somehow cannot be burnt by the flames that are ever blazing in hell. This tortuous worms of hell, exist there in their multi-billions, to the extent that any one soul that is in hell, might be inhabited and infested by hundreds if not thousands of worms. And this worms, are perpetually always digging in and digging out from the flesh of each and every soul that is in hell. They do this digging in and digging out of the flesh, randomly and in succession, so that at any given time, there may be tens to hundreds of worms that are burrowing into the flesh, and at the same time tens or hundred are burrowing out of the flesh. This induces a continuous non-ending stream of pain, from the constant biting and digging in and out of these 6-inch plus worms of hell. The biting and burrowing of these worms makes the souls in hell, to writhe and wiggle in perpetual pain, and even grind their teeth as these worms are digging in and out of their flesh. Those infested by too many worms, eventually get their entire flesh totally consumed by the worms, or falling in pieces on the floor due to the many holes that are in their bodies. But any large-scale destruction inflicted on the body by the worms, is mended by hell refreshing the flesh of the soul in hell, so that he or she receives a brand new body with brand new flesh, which the worms can now bite and burrow through afresh. The third torment that consumes each and every soul that ends up in hell, is torment through the torture by the demons. Now hell was created by God for Satan and his demons, and so after their rebellion in heaven, God confined and imprisoned all the demons inside hell in their multi-billions. However, since the power of hell has been diminished, in order for hell to be able to torment human beings, the billions of demons that are in hell can now tolerate the fire and the torments of hell, since they are creatures of greater strength, power, and endurance compared to human beings. Since the demons can tolerate the conditions of hell, they make it their business to just walk and fly around in hell, amongst the tormented human souls, torturing them just for their amusement. The demons therefore work and fly all over hell with spears, blades, knives, clubs, whips, etc., which they use to pierce, stab, cut, beat up and whip the human souls that are being tormented in the midst of the flames. Other demons just use their hideousness to go around scaring the peoples that are in the midst of the flames. The demons experience sadistic pleasure while tormenting the condemned souls of hell. Some of them would approach a human soul that is going through his or her perpetual torment, and then start stabbing them everywhere, while laughing and enjoying the anguish and eternal hopelessness of their state. Some of them even cut whole body parts of a soul, and stand by and watch that soul going through torment, without a hand, without a head, without an arm, etc. The demons are very evil and sadistic. They continuously go back and forth in hell, piercing, stabbing and cutting the souls that are being tormented in the midst of the flames, with spears, swords, knives, etc. The fourth torment that inflicts torture and suffering to all the souls that are in hell is the unquenchable thirst for water. The human body needs water in order to survive and flourish. In fact, in the world there is a saying that says that water is life. But in hell there is no water, so all the souls that end up in hell are tormented with having a perpetual and unquenchable thirst for water. They long for water, they fantasize in their minds about drinking water, and reminisce how refreshing drinking water was on earth, but they can never drink water, and to make it worse, they can never die of dehydration. The souls in hell are therefore in a constant state of dehydration at any given moment in time, but they can never get even a drop of water to drink. Some of them even try to cry, so that they may collect their tears to drink, but their tears evaporate immediately they come out of their eyes, for the heat around them cannot allow water to exist in liquid form. The fifth torment that afflicts all the souls that find themselves in hell, is the lack of air. Hell is a place saturated with burning sulfur, and sulfur vapor, not to mention the smell of rotten flesh and burning flesh. Whatever air that is there, is largely used up by the burning sulfur flames, and the rest is polluted with toxic sulfur vapor, sulfur oxides and hydrogen sulfide, that contributes to the rotten smell of hell. As a result, there is little or no air for the human souls that are burning in the flames. The souls that end up in hell therefore suffer constant and perpetual gasping for air. They are always gasping for air, and when they try to breathe, they breathe in a concoction of sulfur vapor and its poisons, which scorch their throats and lungs. The souls in hell are therefore in a constant perpetual state of asphyxiation, gasping for air indefinitely, without ever truly suffocating or dying due to lack of air. This perpetual suffocation due to lack of air without really dying, adds to the torments and torture of hell, and it increases the anguish of the souls inside hell. The sixth torment that inflicts torture and suffering on all the souls that are in hell, regardless of what took them there, is their conscience that is constantly and relentlessly always reminding them of all they had done on earth that was sinful and evil. The consciences of all those in hell continuously scolds them, convicts them, and accuses them regarding their evil deeds, making them feel so horrible, depressed and fed up. They try to shut down their conscience, like they had been able to do on earth, so that it may stop accusing them, but they cannot. The control they had while on earth over their consciences is now fully in the hands of hell. And hell uses this control to torment them. So their consciences torments them perpetually, making them to have so much pain in their hearts, and this is one of the torments of hell that is shared among all souls that enter there. The seventh torment that is commonly shared among all those who go to hell is the memory of the loved ones that the damned soul had left behind on earth. The soul in hell is always tormented by the memories of his or her loved ones which they left behind on earth. Their torment comes in the fact that they desperately don't want their loved ones to end up in the torments of hell, and yet they don't have any means of conveying the message to their loved ones on earth. This unquenchable desperation is another torment that hell imposes on all the souls that end up in hell. The eighth torment that exerts on all souls that end up in hell is the perpetual non-ending sadness and hopelessness that consumes all souls in hell, inducing a perpetual state of depression that never ends. This torment comes from the fact that there is no love in hell, and human beings are love-dependent beings. When you disconnect them from the flow of love, then they become sad and hopeless and plunge into a state of depression. This perpetual sadness, hopelessness, and depression because of lack of love is yet another torment that hell exerts on the souls that end up in there. So the basic universal torture and torment mechanisms of hell upon the soul of a person in hell include burning in the flames of hell, constant biting and burrowing of the flesh by the 6-inch worms, constant torture by the sadistic demons through stabbing, piercing, cutting, and beatings through spears, swords, knives, clubs and whips, the unquenchable perpetual thirst for water, the constant perpetual suffocation and gasping for air, the constant and perpetual pangs of hunger, the constant accusation by one's conscience, and the remembrance of the people you left on the earth, desperately wanting them not to come to hell, and also the perpetual sadness and hopelessness. All this torments afflict all the souls that are in hell all at the same time, making their existence horrible and miserable. That's why I said that you should not wish hell on anybody, not even your worst enemy. Because you can imagine that the soul in hell is being burnt by the flames of hell, at the same time he or she is being bitten and burrowed by hundreds of 6-inch worms, and at the same time the demons are walking back and forth stabbing, beating and piercing them with spears, swords and clubs, and at the same time they are consumed by a thirst for water that they can never quench, and at the same time they are suffocating and gasping for air, and at the same time they are famished with starvation and cannot eat, and at the same time their consciences are accusing them and making them feel so horrible about themselves, and at the same time they are so desperate that their loved ones back on earth don't come to hell, and also at the same time they are sad, depressed, and hopeless. So you can imagine all this torments acting on one soul continually and perpetually forever, never giving the soul a moment's rest. You can imagine the level of pain, suffering and anguish it produces in them. No wonder some of them end up cursing their mother's womb for bringing them to existence. Hell is so horrible and it is not meant for human beings, but because of the continued persistence and stubbornness of human beings, in clinging to evil, sin and wickedness, majority of human beings end up in hell.